everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you my polish pickup wishlist for January of 2024. Now, one of my goals for this year is to not buy that many polishes, but I still like to look at them. And compared to other months, I think I did a pretty decent job of not picking too many polishes this month. January does not look like it has a lot of things that I'm interested in. There's like two that I almost count as must-haves, but we'll see if I actually purchase them when the time comes. My goal is to skip at least 6 months of polish pickup if I can, or have just two products to buy and that's it, instead of buying like 4, 5, 6. I was very proud of the fact that in 2023, I didn't buy polish pickup since November of 2022. So I was very proud of that until about July. When July Rewind Month came about, I started buying polish pickup again and I didn't stop until the end of the year. So yeah, this is gonna be something that I'm gonna actively try not to do. But anyways, have you all been to the polish pickup website? Because it got a makeover and I, for one, am digging it. I love it. It looks so fun and bright. I love the color combinations. So I like it. And it even has the theme on the top. It says theme deadly plants. It also says that pre-order is January the 5th through the 8th. I was gonna say the 1st through the 1st. I'm like, wait a minute, no, that's just me, one and one. So I really like that. This is awesome. And look, it pauses when you put your mouse on it. I am digging this. So I'm gonna actually start doing this in alphabetical order from A to Z this month. I don't have a lot of non-polished items on my wish list. So let's get started with the first one. The first polish that is on my wish list, the one that is a must-have, like number one must-have, if I get nothing else, I want this, is Beau Rev's Lacquer in Blooming Azalea. It's gonna be $12. Oh God, wait, hold on. I have to click now. Inspired by azaleas, Blooming Azalea has a base that shifts from plum mauve magenta, green aqua shimmer, and peachy pink magnetics. There is no cap on this one and it will be $12. I think I already said that. I'm trying to say mauve instead of mauve because apparently Americans say mauve and it's supposed to be mauve. So I'm just gonna go with it. I'm trying to pronounce it like the rest of the world pronounces it. Anywho, this, oh, I'm gonna click here. Oh, look at how big this is. So it's a magnetic. So this polish was introduced to me by Atticus Loves Lacquer on Instagram. And I saw his reel on Instagram and I was just like, what is this? What is this magic? So I completely blame it on him for doing this to me. Like, he totally did this to me. This is a gorgeous, gorgeous polish. I mean, oh my goodness. Look how amazing this polish looks. Oh, I love it. I don't love this green, like over here in the bottle where you can see mostly green. Let me get a bottle shot. Where you see mostly green and the pink base, I'm kind of leery about that, but magnetized, it looks like it doesn't have that much of that green gold shimmer. I'm really, really loving this. This looks amazing. So if I get nothing else, I'm definitely gonna get this Beau Rev's, and it would be my first official Beau Rev's polish because I don't have any polishes from this brand. The next polish that I'm interested in is by Vanessa Molina in Dangerous Beauty. This is gonna be $13 and it is inspired by the flowers of this, I can't say that, which has the power to paralyze muscles including the heart. The description states it's a jelly green ivy base, iridescent flakes, mix of aurora pigment and holographic flake with purple and magenta meadow flakes, and it will be capped at 500. The only reason why I like this is because it's so different than anything else I have. Like, it is so different. It's so different from anything else I have. This is what's really attracting me to this polish, but I'm not sure if I really, really like it. I'm gonna put it in my wish list for now, but this one, if anything has to go, this is the first one that's gonna go because it's interesting and different, but at the same time, I don't know. I feel like it's a total Monet, you know? Like, it looks good from far away, but up front is just a big old mess. That's what I'm getting from this polish. It's beautiful, but at the same time, I don't like it. But I like it. Does that make sense? I don't know. That's how I'm feeling. Next, we have Colores de Carol in Deadliest One of All. This is going to be $13.50, and it's inspired by this right here. And Deadliest One of All is a white crelly with green indigo violet aurora shimmer, green hollow glitter, emerald shreds, white glitters, and green diamond flakes. No cap on this one. This polish. I am so digging this polish. I think it was back when... Does anybody remember, like, Moo Moo Lacquers? I don't remember what their name was. I haven't seen them on PPU in a while, but maybe it's because I haven't been looking. But they came out with a polish that was a white base with green flakes and white, like, glitters in there, and I fell in love with it. And I skipped it on PPU because their bottle size was really small, and I was just not into their price for the amount you get ratio. So I skipped it, and I kept talking about it and kept talking about it. I'm sure my polish friends were really, really tired of me talking about that polish. And then I think it came back at some point, and I saw more swatches of it, and I was just like, I don't like it. Well, this polish reminds me of that, but better. Now, I will say that it does kind of also remind me of Bees Knees Lacquer Holiday Cheermeister, which I do have, but this has more components than Holiday Cheermeister has. Yeah, this is one of those that I'm probably gonna get. Like, if I'm just gonna get two, I want to get this one and the Beau Revs. Those are the two that I'm like, yeah, this is probably gonna come home to me. Next, we have KB Shimmer, How You Doing? $12 even, and it's inspired by Wolf's Bane. How You Doing nail polish features a daring blue shimmer that pops against a near indigo base. It has a scattering of hollow bits, and that's pretty much it. It says it does capture the view, captivates with views of indigo and purple hues at different angles. I love blues. So this automatically drew my eye, but looking at it up close, I have something similar, or if not similar, I just don't need it. I don't need it. I don't like those little hollow flakes. I don't know. No. I feel like I have something similar. In fact, it's kind of giving me, I have a Never Naked by Jackie that I wore for the holiday season that has very, very, very similar look to this. So I think I'm going to skip out on this one. I'm going to take it off from my wish list because as beautiful as it is, and I know that KB Shimmer has an amazing formula, I feel like I already can see something else that I have like it, and I don't need it. So I'm going to take this one off. Next, we have Lynn B. Designs Dudley Nude Shit. Wait, what? Let's try this again. Lynn B. Designs Dudley Nudshite. I hope I'm saying that right. It's going to be $13 and there is no cap on it. It is inspired by Deadly Nightshade and what I accidentally called it at one time. Now it's all I call Deadly Nightshade. Okay. Sorry. I thought I wasn't reading that right. Anywho, it's a deep berry jelly base filled with green to blue shifting shimmer. Deadly Nightshade. I'm sorry. Oh God. I was reading it again and I just started laughing. Anywho, this polish is gorgeous. I love it. This looks so pretty. I have a couple of Lynn B. Designs now and I have to say I'm super impressed with their formula. The only thing that's causing me not to get this polish is that I feel like I have a multi-chrome that's very similar to this, like from Tonic Polish. I'm thinking of a Tonic Polish that is very similar. And I don't like the way that it looks here. Like over here, I don't like the way it looks here. I like this. But I don't know, this mauve looking thing, I'm just not in, I don't know. See, I like this. But I don't like the way it looks here. I don't know. Am I crazy? I think I'm crazy. I'm definitely crazy. I don't know. I'm kind of on the fence about this one. It looks beautiful, though. I'm going to keep it on my wish list for now, but this is probably going to get kicked to the curb once I start buckling down on my choices. Next, we have Nailed It in Compulsion. This is going to be $13, and there is going to be a cap of $400. It's inspired by the Vervain from the Vampire Diaries universe. Yeah, I've never read that book series. The sheer lavender base with strong green to blue shifting shimmer and hollow flakes. This looks so pretty. I love colors like this. I mean, I love colors like this. What more can I say? I love colors like this. This is gorgeous. I don't feel like I have something like it, but maybe something similar enough. I don't know. I'd have to like go through my collection. Certain photos makes it look a little frosty. Like, I feel like this looks too frosty and it makes me not like it. And then I see it like here and I'm like, oh yeah, that's pretty. And then I see it here and I'm like, oh yeah, that's pretty. And then I see it here and I'm like, oh yeah, that's pretty. Where the heck did this frost come from? Yeah, like over here it looks kind of frosty. I don't know. Over here looks a little frosty too. I don't know. I like it over here. I don't know. So many choices. Looks, see, it kind of looks frosty in some nails. I don't know. Maybe I'm just nitpicking to try to get this off my wish list. Right now, I'm going to get it off the wish list. Like, the more I look at it, the more I'm like, do I really want that? I don't know. So we're going to kick it out and go with another polish. And the last polish that I have to share with you all is Polish for Days Angel Wings. This is going to be $13.50, and there is no cap. It's inspired by Angel Wing Caladium. I don't know. I'm saying that wrong. It's a pink base with strong green to blue shifting iridescent shimmer. I'm back in love with my Polish for Days. Like, I'm back on that horse. I love Polish for Days again. Towards the end of 2023, I started purchasing more Polish for Days again. I started wearing more Polish for Days. Actually, I think I actually wore a lot of Polish for Days in 2023, and it kind of reignited my love for this brand. I mean, this was one of the first indie brands that I really, really fell hardcore for, like where I would buy their collection every time they'd come out. Every single polish pickup that they come out with, I was getting the For the Love of Polish boxes. Not every month, but you know, I was pretty routinely getting them, even if I didn't like the other polishes, because I liked the Polish for Days and I needed it. I stopped that habit, which is good. That was a lot of money. But this right here, it looks really pretty. I don't know. I feel like, okay, honestly, oh God, that looks so pretty. But honestly, at this picture right here, and this picture right here, and this picture right here, it reminds me of a Bee's Knees lacquer, but it looks more opaque than the Bee's Knees lacquer. However, these people's nails are shorter than mine. So, all of that to say, see, this is longer nails, and I went on a tangent. All of that to say is that I'm kind of torn about this polish, and then I said, see, this one has a little bit more opacity. Like, she has longer nails, and you can tell that it's opaque. And look at that shift at that angle. Oh my gosh. You all, I am freaking out. I'm seriously freaking out. I love the way that this looks. Oh, this is gonna be tough. Okay. I need to go through my... This looks so beautiful. Look at that. Look at... Sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sure that was really annoying. Okay, so yeah, I'm loving this. This is definitely staying in my wish list. And I decided to get rid of the Lin B Designs just based on this alone. It is so beautiful. Oh, and the Vanessa Molina. Yeah, I'm totally removing the Vanessa Molina from my wish list, and this is all I'm gonna keep. So right now we have three polishes in my wish list. I'm very torn about these three polishes because they're all something I want. Okay, so like looking at them in this little square, I feel like the Beau Revs looks very similar to the Polish for Days, but the Beau Revs is a magnetic. I'm saying that wrong. The bow one is a magnetic, and it will look different once applied. The shade of pink is different, but yes, seeing them in these little squares, I'm kind of like, I think I have a type. And then there's los colores de Carol. I don't know what to say. This is going to be hard. This is going to be a hard month. And I only have three. Oh my gosh. Anywho, so this is it. This is what's on my wish list. Let me know in the comments down below if you all have the same polishes on your wish list. I would be very interested to see what you have in mind for this month. I honestly was not impressed with a lot of the polishes, but you know what? I think about that one month when they had flora and fauna and I heard the theme and I was like, this is stupid. And then that was like my favorite month ever. From polish makeup, like ever. I loved so many from that month and I thought the theme was stupid. So I try not to judge anything by the theme, but sometimes a theme can get me excited and sometimes it can just make me go like ho-hum. This theme was kind of ho-hum for me. Looking at the majority of them, they kind of were ho-hum to me too. I didn't find a lot of things that I'm attracted to, but I feel very strongly about these three. So it's going to be hard to narrow it down to two because I said two, right? I said two. All right. So thank you everyone so much for listening to me ramble. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give me a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see y'all in my next one. Bye.